This is the Sabbath School lesson for the third quarter, 2020.
Thursday, August 13. Sharing the Word. Good news is for sharing. Think about the times in your life that you have been delighted with good news. It may have been the day you were engaged to be married, the birth of a child, a new job, or the purchase of a new car or home. You were so excited that you could not wait to share. It is wonderful to share our joy with others, but the best news in the entire universe is the story of Jesus. When we discover new insights in his word about the salvation that there is in Christ, our hearts overflow with joy, and we long to tell someone else. When the religious authorities tried to stop the preaching of the apostles, Peter declared in Acts chapter 4, verse 20, "For we cannot but speak the things which we have seen and heard." And in Steps to Christ, page 78, we read, "No sooner does one come to Christ than there is born in his heart a desire to make known to others what a precious friend he has found in Jesus. The saving and sanctifying truth cannot be shut up in his heart. If we are clothed with the righteousness of Christ and are filled with the joy of his indwelling spirit, we shall not be able to hold our peace." End of quote. In Romans 1, verses 14 to 16, Paul wrote, "I am debtor both to the Greeks and to the barbarians, both to the wise and to the unwise. So, as much as in me is, I am ready to preach the gospel to you that are at Rome also. For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth, to the Jew first, and also to the Greek." The Apostle Paul never tired of telling his conversion story. His heart overflowed with joy in Jesus. For him, good news was for sharing, and he could not be quiet. Question? What vital principles about sharing the word of God do Isaiah 50 verse 4, Ecclesiastes 3 verse 1, and 2 Timothy 4 verse 2 give us? First of all, Isaiah chapter 50 and verse 4. "The Lord God has given me the tongue of the learned, that I should know how to speak, a word in season to him who is weary. He awakens me morning by morning, he awakens my ear to hear as the learned." And Ecclesiastes 3 verse 1, "To everything there is a season, a time for every purpose under heaven." And 2 Timothy 4 verse 2, "Preach the word, be ready in season and out of season. Convince, rebuke, exhort with all long-suffering and teaching." As we surrender our lives to Christ and his service, he will open doors of opportunity for us to speak a word in season or at the right time to those whose hearts he has opened. In all of our witnessing, we must keep three biblical principles in mind: what we say, how we say it, and when we say it. So to finish today, who are some people with whom you are in contact, and how can you be a better witness to them?
Hi there. Thanks for watching this video on the Advent-band Ministries YouTube channel. Please subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon to be alerted whenever we upload new videos. So, until we meet him in the clouds, may God continue to bless you.
This lesson was read by Dr. Percy Harrold for Christian Services for the Blind and Hearing Impaired, Christian Record Services for the Blind, the Sabbath School Department, and Hope Channel. You can also listen on the official Sabbath School 4 app and the Apple iTunes app, Sabbath School with Percy Harrold. Remember, God is always faithful.